On the one hand, particularly for a very open and volatile economy like the Dutch, it makes a lot of sense to build buffers during an economic uptick. Because if the economy is going down, you actually do need that money. And our type of economy really feels what happens in the global economy. So if the world is doing well, we're doing very well. But the reverse is also true.
But the world is doing well. The world has been doing well. And so, Netherlands haven't been spending.
Well, we've actually managed to outspend most of the Dutch governments of the last number of decades. And we will further increase, and that will be my second point, will we further increase our spending next year and the year thereafter. So we're doing that just as well.
So talk to me about the French plan. Obviously, they've devised a plan for a common eurozone budget out of 2021. Now, you've told the press recently that you would be willing to walk away from that plan unless national governments have a veto power. Why the hardline approach here?
Well, actually, our take is very much in line with the tasking that the government leaders gave us in December. And we're now tasked with thinking what the design could look like. And what I've tried to articulate is that for the Netherlands, it is very important that when we have this budgetary instrument, and if we have it, we are clear on that it is used for reforms and that there is clear conditionality in place. And if we manage to do that, it might be a tool for the better. If we don't, then it is difficult to see how it could be helpful. But we're open to having the discussion, and we're currently having the discussion with the other finance ministers as we speak.
But do you not think that time is running out? Because the conversations that I have with people is, you know, many people are worried that the eurozone good years are maybe coming to an end because of the slowdown. We know that the ECB is very close or at limits to what they could enact. So the onus is really on governments and on eurozone as a whole to become more integrated from a fiscal perspective. Are you willing to bear the responsibility of being one of the few countries that gets in the way of that happening?
Well, frankly speaking, it starts with the responsibility that each country needs to take on its own. So there is the European infrastructure, and it is very important to make steps, for example, in the banking union on that specific front. At the same time, the responsibility of fiscal discipline, of pushing through reforms, of doing the right thing now that the economy is still relatively okay, that is what governments need to do. That is true for my own, but it is true for the others as well. And that is the best way to navigate any future crisis.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.